Oh, so after that, we ended up having to do a total radical hysterectomy, which means I am 30 and in menopause. That's fun. So after those, I started 18 rounds of chemo once a week for 18 weeks, taxol, carboplatin. I lost all my hair, all my eyebrows, all my eyelashes.
Yep.
I was a naked mole rat, and it was, I mean, I hit it pretty well. There are clients that still like are figuring out, oh, you have cancer? I'm like, yeah, I've had cancer. And they didn't know that I was bald underneath my wigs and my makeup and my fake lashes. So I got in remission. It was a pretty easy as far as like chemo goes, other than being bald. And then in the 6 months between, I got married, went on my honeymoon, and then we started having weird blood tests and weird numbers again. And they did a scan and a biopsy, and the beast was back after about 6 months. 6 months is when we got our first weird scan. And in November, December last year, we started doing those diagnostics and getting me ready for another round of chemo, which is doxil and carboplatin, which is a lot harsher, but it also causes a lot less hair loss. I think I lost about like 10 to 20%, but no one could tell me if I was going to lose all of it or none of it or a little bit of it, because like the chemo nurse and the oncologist were saying opposite things. And so I'm sitting there going, I am not going to go through this shit without a nice wig again. Especially, I'm used to having long hair. My hair was to my waist my entire life. And I was just growing it back. It was maybe like that long on top by my wedding. And I contacted Jane. I'm like, look, this is back. I don't want to be a naked mole rat again. I'm going to get one of your wigs. So if it falls out, then I don't have to deal with it, because wig store wigs are itchy and terrible. And if it doesn't, then like my head's not going to be cold, because I'm really sensitive to heat and cold now. It's a really bizarre feeling. Chemo's weird. I have two more left, and I found out on my scan on this past Monday that all the cancer is gone.
Yay!
Oh, I'm so glad. I'm so glad.
And they're
so
going glad. To put me on an oral medication to help keep it in remission.
Yes.
Hopefully. But yeah, and this is my power port on my chest. They just like plug you in there. So no IVs every week. Everyone hates needles.
I just want to say, when I met her, we were talking for a while, and because I take my daughter there to get her hair done, and just her energy and her spirit was just so attractive. I was like, and then I found out what she was going through. I was like, this is what, maybe over a year ago, and I'm like, how do you stay so positive? How do you smile? How do you fight through this? Because there's somebody out there that could use that. What keeps you going?
A lot of it is a coping mechanism. I met a girl very early on through Instagram. I actually met a lot of wonderful women my age dealing with this through Instagram. Average age for ovarian cancer, 65 plus. And she told me that she survived stage 4 by telling herself that it was not going to get her. She was going to get through this. And she wasn't going to let it hold her down. So I just adopted that mindset, because it's better than being anxious and miserable all the time. So I just threw myself into my hair and my makeup and my social media. And everyone's like, oh, you're on Facebook all the time. Yeah, I don't have anything else to do when I'm in bed. I'm just sitting there like this.
Yeah.
But I refused to accept defeat.
Yes.
And it was scary at first, because I didn't know a whole lot about how the cancer worked and like how the treatments worked. So I started doing a lot of research, and there's a lot of like pseudoscience and woo about diets and all that, and like homeopathic cures for cancers. And I'm like, yeah, that's not worth taking that risk. I'm gonna listen to my oncologist. So I asked him questions, and I asked him like details, and I wanted to see my scans, I wanted to see my paperwork, and I kept on top of it. And I met a lot of women that are also his patients through the chemo center, and it was just shocking how many didn't know the facts behind like what was going on in their body. So I think being on top of it and knowing it, and then meeting people that have been through the degree that I have and also worse, and survived it has helped. I mean, I met a woman through chemo. There was actually two important women that I met through chemo. One of them actually unfortunately passed away last week. Her kidneys couldn't handle the chemo, so they had to stop and put her in hospice. She was older. She was wonderful, though. And then the other one, this woman's like 70, and she's had ovarian cancer for almost 10 years, and it's been almost nonstop, like no real remission. She's still trucking.
Nice.
Yeah, and she's
my
just,
kind of girl.
Yeah. So I just looked at that. I'm like, you know what? In 7 or 8 years, they're going to have a lot more treatments for this. Immunotherapy is right on the verge of having a breakthrough for ovarian. I mean, they're going to get this.
100%.
And yes. Maybe a couple years down the road would have been a better time to get this if there was a good time. But, you know, now's not bad, I guess. But I got through it, and I think also a major thing for cancer patients is even though it's hard and even though you're tired and you're exhausted and you feel like your body's just betraying you, you gotta try and keep that schedule. Just try and do your normal as much as you possibly can. I mean, I've worked this whole time. Like, I didn't take any time off for my first round of chemo, and for this one, because it's a lot harsher, I do have to take a week off a month, but I work 4 days a week, 8 hours a day, and it's hard, but I maintain me.
Yeah.
Maintaining yourself becoming the cancer. Yeah.
I just want to thank you for sharing your story with our amazing audience. It's important for us women to support one another. And I know there's someone out there who needed to hear this, and I just thank you. I admire you so much for your strength and your beauty, and just you're gorgeous on the outside, but it's beyond that. You're just a light, and that's what attracted me to you. Even when you weren't even doing our hair, I was like, who's that? What's her name? Give me your number.
That's what I say about her.
You're so sweet. I truly love you. Us here at the Virginia Fantasy, you got us. Our prayers are with you. And you're so strong. And we just want you to continue to be strong and being yourself.
Thank you, Jane.
But today, we're going to play in some hair.
Yes!
Before that, I want you guys to check out her haircut. Like,
check
at this
out.
Chick
check
right
this
here.
This is by...
Look at this chick right here.
This is by Lena Petrova at
nice.
Salon Red in Candler Park, Atlanta.
Nice! She did a great job.
Yeah.
Well, let's play in some hair. Oh, thank you so much.